zoning ordinance to include the raising or keeping of no more than 4 female chickens as permitted. Anyone here to introduce the paper?
Sorry, this is another one of the chicken papers. You want to do it right there?
Right, thank you. This will set the zoning change in motion. Is there any discussion?
This paper is continuing.
No, this is moving forward to set the...
So the zoning, okay, I'm moving forward.
The other paper can.
This is 60-day paper, correct?
Correct.
Okay. I make a motion that we move it forward.
Public comment first.
Right.
Is there any public comment for or against this paper? Seeing none?
Now, can I make a motion?
Thank you.
Thank you. I make a motion that we move it forward with our approval to the April 8th council meeting.
It's going to planning commission first.
Go to planning.
Yes. I will second that motion and move item number 14.
Mr. Lawson?
Yes, ma'am.
Let me confirm this agreement, but I think this resolution...
Mr. Bimba, can you come back before you...
I believe this resolution has to be approved by council, and then an ordinance will be introduced, and that's the ordinance that will go to the planning commission and then back to council. So this paper will be going to council on the 25th.
I'm asking that this paper be approved, or recommended for approval tonight.
To the 25th.
To the 25th, it should be adopted, we're willing, and then... Then the ordinance portion of it comes into the situation.
Okay, may I change my motion to say that...
Mr. Bimba's eager comment.
Not, you called me.
One of the experts here while we're getting this straight.
What is the question?
This paper will be moved to February 25th, council meeting. And then the ordinance will go through the planning commission and return here on April 8th. So the zoning portion of the chickens.
The zoning portion of chicken has to have an ONR, it's got to have a law department.
Right.
And you're looking at introduction on that ONR on March 11th.
Okay.
That would then take back to council on April 8th. That would be the quickest it could be done, you could process that zoning paper.
So this resolution will end up on Monday's docket for full city council approval?
Correct. And then the ONR will follow suit. That's correct.
Okay. So the motion is to...
To move it to, is our approval to the February 25th?
I will second that motion and move the paper forward. Any public comment? Or, I'm sorry. Item number 16, please.
Item number 16, ordinance number 2013-21, to authorize the CIO to execute the necessary documents and take the necessary steps to complete the rails, the trails, conversion of a portion of the railroad property known as James River Industrial Track for the property known as 3111 Water Street to the city's corporate boundaries for the Virginia Capital Trail Project. We have someone here to introduce that paper.
Mr. Carroll. Thank you, good afternoon. I'm Carroll from Department of Public Works. This paper is in relation to implementation of Virginia Capital Trail in the city of Richmond. The rail to trail is a federal process. This is a step process. Under this, where Surface Transportation Board in Washington, D.C. allows throughout the nationwide that if any tracks they are abandoned, then the rail line can request by an application to Surface Transportation Board that they can approve abandonment of rail line. And then second step is localities, they can request abandoned track to use as a public trail. So this is the process has to take place. In the meantime, before they approve or disapprove, they have a public hearing. That has about a 60-day process. In this case, Virginia Capital Trail in the city of Richmond, they have three segments. Segment one from 17th Street to Great Shakes dog park, that's already implemented. Segment is from Shiplock Park to Lehigh Cement Factory. That's under development right now. So this particular location is on segment three, starts from Lehigh Cement Factory, go east city limit. Back in last October, as Lehigh Cement Factory is in the process of relocation, they have notified CSX and Norfolk Southern Railroad both that they have discontinued using rail line to serve their industry. They're only using trucking as a for the service. So based on their notification, CSX is in the process to notify Surface Transportation Board and put a formal application to them to allow them to abandon the tracks. And that application will be going out to the board this week. This ordinance, once it's approved next week in the council action, then CAO, on behalf of City Council, will file another application to Surface Transportation Board to allow city to use abandoned track as it for the trade purposes. So this is a step process, and we want to follow it very closely because we want to implement the trail. The trail right now is being designed on the same footprints where the tracks, they are abandoned. They are being abandoned right now. So we have about 75% design complete on the trail project. With that, I can answer any question regarding the rail to trail or the process of capital trail.
Any questions? Do you have any discussion? Anybody wishing to speak in favor or against this paper?
Silver Persinger, citizen of Richmond, Virginia. I'd like to express my support for this paper. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Persinger. There's no other public comment. We will bring it back to the committee.
I move that we move this forward to full council.
I will second that motion and do so for the next council meeting. Item number 17, please.
Item number 17, ordinance number 2013-31. To name an unnamed alley in the block bounded by Troy Avenue, North Belmont Avenue, Grove Avenue, North Harmon Avenue, that runs along the south and west boundaries of the property known as 100 North Belmont Avenue, 102 North Belmont Avenue, 104 North Belmont Avenue, and 3107 Lord Grove Alley, as Berthers Country Lane. And we have an introduction, please.
This is a paper that I put in at the request of some of the neighbors in that neighborhood. Mrs. Burke has lived at that address for, I believe it's something along the lines of 67 years. Her husband, who just recently passed away, unfortunately, has lived there, I think, since 20. Mrs. Burke's kind of a special lady. She tends the alley next to her house, which is next to her garden, and she's even has an agreement with public works that they know not to come in and mess with her alley because she tends it and treats it like a country lane and grows grass and mow it. And it's at the neighbor's request that they ask me to introduce this. So I'm happy to do it. And if there's anybody that has any public comment for or against it,
so, Persinger, citizen of Richmond, Virginia. Thank you for a little bit of background, Mr. Belisle. So, I think City Council actually needs to develop a process for public inclusion in the naming of alleys. A lot of times, this process is led by developers, and they basically make the alley name whatever they want. The most objectionable example of this is Mr. French, the developer, who may still be in jail for fraud or forgery, but he named an alley between 3rd and 2nd, between Cary and Maine, Griffin French Alley. That's the name of his son. We have a convicted Felton's son with an alley named after him. Existing city, I guess it's in the city code, prohibits the naming of buildings and other city structures after living people. And I think that's a good idea because you don't know what these people are going to do in their lives, especially a child or something like that. And I think giving developers this sort of power to name an alleyway without the consent of the people who live in the neighborhood is a gross violation of public trust. And I've mentioned this before several times over the course of the years, but you guys, in particular this committee, should develop a process for public inclusion of naming of alleys, because right now the public isn't part of the process. But in your instance, it sounds like your neighbors are supportive of this name, so I guess I can support that. Thank you.
Thank you. I will point out that nobody on that alley is a developer. Everybody that lives on the alley is in support of the renaming of Pittsburgh. So, there's a committee discussion.
I just commend the neighbor. I'm happy to have an alley named for her and make a motion to move this forward.
I will second that. Thank you very much. And last item, please.
Last item, item number 18, ordinance number 2013-14, to authorize the CAO to convey site development easements, including but not limited to easements for ingress, egress, utilities, cable, telecommunications, stormwater management, and other similar conveyances across the public property located at 1701 Fairfield Way for the purpose of the construction. Richmond City Justice Center. We have someone here to introduce that paper.
Good afternoon. My name is Chris Beschler. I would just like to put a few clarifying facts on this paper. As the paper indicates, it's authorized the CAO on behalf of the City of Richmond to convey site development easements. One thing that I do want to make very, very clear is that there's two major restrictions on this. One is that it's specific to the property of 1701 Fairfield Way, which is the location of the Justice Center. And even further, it's very specific to those easements that are required for the construction of the project. So it's not the ability to sign blanket easements anywhere in the city. It's very specific in nature. The purpose of the paper is to help keep that project on track. I have before me an easement from Dominion that we need to sign to get permanent power to the facility. And one thing that this paper will do is help facilitate us keeping the project on schedule so that every time a utility requires an easement, we don't have to come to the property.
Thank you, Special.
Questions from the
Opened it up to public comment for or against. Seeing none.
Back to